Well, we got the jet pipe off and the nozzle. And now that we have a chance, while we're disassembling the engine to get it out of the test cell, let's get a close-up look at all this afterburner stuff. This is the flame holder. You can see it's just basically an aerodynamic device to cause a zone of low velocity air. This is the torch igniter. Let's take a top look. There it is there. And deep inside, I don't know if you can see way in there. Here's the body of a torch igniter. And on the right is the hole for the fuel nozzle. On the left is the hole for the igniter plug. And I've got both those pieces right here. This is the fuel nozzle. There's the inlet drain. There is the head of the fuel nozzle. Let's look a little closer. This one hasn't been cleaned, but you can see the orifice through which the fuel is sprayed and the collar that matches up and forms part of a seal in the body of the torch igniter. That's the fuel nozzle. And here is the igniter plug. You can see this is the engine side. Loops around the bottom, comes up. And it's a surface mount spark plug. Or surface gap spark plug. Right there, the torch igniter plug. The fuel, the air, and the spark combine to spit flame out of this guy, which starts your afterburner. The way it goes, that's sideways. It's this way. There you go. And this goes in just like that. There's the collar. Right there. So the whole thing is going to look something like that. And it's a very large spark that comes out of there, as you've seen with our tests. Let's go underneath, and there, this is the ignition lead, right there, and this, behind it, that's the fuel line to the fuel nozzle inside the torch igniter. Now, past that, or forward of that in the engine actually, you've got, let's see, that's a afterburner spray bar to spray fuel. One thing I didn't notice or didn't mention last time, you can see it here, that thing, and there's another one there. Those are the thermocouples for measuring exhaust gas temperature. This is a strut. That big thing is a strut that basically holds the rear bearing in the center of the case. And then, of course, there's the turbine blades. All this stuff close up. And you can see the flame holder is mounted on hinges. It's allowed to expand and contract a great deal because it gets very hot. Very hot. Let's see if I can reach in there all the way. Can I reach past all this stuff? Can I do it? And I can just make it. There we go. That's the turbine. The third stage of the three-stage turbine. And the back end of this afterburning J79 minus the afterburner pipe, which is right behind us. Let's do a very slow and careful. There's the can it gets shipped in. And there are the bolts that attach it. That is the afterburner duct. Right here. It weighs about 300 pounds. It's quite lightweight because there's not much to it. Somebody mentioned the howl of the J79. This engine doesn't make it because these rear pedals, these, and the inner ones, they're longer than the J79 fitted to the Starfighter. So this engine doesn't really howl as much as the Starfighter J79. And there you go, the blasting exhaust gas nozzle.